depth and cover right there.
There he is.
And you know what?
Good one.
It feels pretty good. Oh yeah, it is a good one, George. Oh boy.
Good fish.
Oh, look at this, George. I might need you with here. Oh, nice, George. Dude. Did you grab that one? See? Come right up to you. Oh,
good
Lord.
Fish.
Hey? Good fish. You did say you have to be close to the pillar and dark, right? Isn't that what you said?
Yes, sir.
Exactly. Look where he's got it, too. Oh, my goodness. Look at that. There's nothing wrong with that crappie right there, boys. Wow.
Channel. This one's especially for our friends in Texas, Oklahoma, and anywhere that surrounds the big, beautiful state of Texas. Something about Texas. You know that saying about everything big comes from Texas? Well, the big excitement, big fun, big crappie, and big time friendships I've made over the years in Texas. Well, stick with me for the rest of my days, man. But I want to put something special because a lot of our YouTube followers, people who post, people who make comments and stuff that are from the beautiful Lone Star State. And I wanted to thank you personally and just maybe rekindle some of those trips that I've made to Texas, fishing with some great crappie fishermen, including this first segment from Gun Barrel City, Texas, on Cedar Creek Lake with a good buddy, George S. Nealon. George, man, that guy, what a crappie fisherman, from shooting docks and bridge pilings and stuff, to this first time we fished together on Cedar Creek Lake. The lake was flooded. George was out for 2 days doing everything he knows how to do to find crappie. They didn't want to cooperate. So he goes up a creek, finds some crappie. We have to, you know, roll up our sleeves, pick up the jig poles, go one-on-one under some bridges. Like, I mean, we really had to hunt them down. This was a lot more like hunting than it is fishing, but I'm telling you, the experience of fishing for crappie in Texas, the lakes are limitless. The seasons from January to December, there's so much opportunity in Texas, it's just waiting for you, like this first segment in a small creek with big fun with my buddy George. Check it out.
Here we are, Cedar Creek Lake out of Gun Barrel City with the Crappie Anglers of Texas. George Nealon and I are gonna have some fun.
Oh no.
That one was meant for the boat, dude.
I received a phone call from Paul O'Beer asking me if I would be interested in fishing with Karl Kalonka.
Oh, I seen that bite. Good fish.
Look where he's got it too. Look at that. Right through that top lip, boy.
All right, so hook up with George and to get everything we need to catch crappie. But the forecast, Mother Nature, and filming fishing shows, sometimes she just throws us a curveball and it's not something you can hit.
There he is, Ken.
Atta boy. George is kicking my butt.
We went to the docks and nothing. I had one more ace up my sleeve and it was up a creek.
We go in this little back creek. The water's all muddy. There's branches and grass and all kinds of mess everywhere. The kind of stuff I like to fish. Oh yeah, good one. Real big one.
Get it.
You're stuck.
When you're fishing crappie like this time of year, you have to go to war with them.
There. Oh yeah.
Like that. There he is.
Oh, he dropped them on the boat.
They're right off the bank. They're tight to cover. They're in little holes.
There's fish.
There's one. Oh, there's a fish. All right, Georgie.
They're around brush, grass, and not always are they that aggressive.
There he is. Look at that. There he is.
In the boat.
Buddy, you can't. That is amazing, man, huh?
Man, you want to talk about effort. These bushes and stuff, you're using 10-foot poles, so there's trees above you, branches, you name it. And those crappie, sometimes they're 3 feet from the bank, sometimes their tails are right against the bank.
Oh,
I seen him.
I seen him. Wow.
I seen him.
Okay, here we are, Cedar Creek Lake out of Gun Barrel City with the Crappie Anglers of Texas called Cat. George Nealon and I are gonna have some fun. See docks like that? Shooting them. You wanna get this little bait as far back in those dark little holes in there, because that's potentially where those big black crappie on Cedar Creek Lake are gonna be. All right, so hook up with George, and he's got this big legend. He's got it all, you know, so I'm impressed. He's got everything we need to catch crappie, but the forecast, Mother Nature, and filming fishing shows, sometimes she just throws us a curveball and not good for crappie.
I received a phone call from Paul O'Beer asking me if I would be interested in fishing with Karl Kalonka. So I knew I had to find some fish, and I spent 2 days fishing the entire lake. But it had rained and rained and rained. There was current, debris, everywhere we went, it was awful. The water was cold, it cooled the water off. It was tough to find fish. We went to the docks and nothing. Went to the dam and nothing. I had one more ace up my sleeve, and it was up a creek.
Where you think them buggers go to the warmest water, you know?
Yeah, and maybe I didn't go far enough back.
When I go to my little sloughs and stuff, that's where I do. I go to the back and work my way out. We go in this little back creek, the water's all muddy, there's branches and grass and all kinds of mess everywhere, the kind of stuff I like to fish for crappie.
There he is right there. That's what
there
I'm talking about.
There he is, right there. Thanks to George and the Crappie Anglers of Texas. Look at that, man. I'm telling you, this is fun, boy. Under bridges, you know, shooting docks, whatever it takes. And there it is right there. That's not a giant, but you know what? That's my first Cedar Creek crappie, black crappie, but it's the way we're catching them, hunting them down. It's Xtreme Crappie, dudes. And that one, it's got a, you know, tight little back. Do you have a size limit and stuff on this lake?
10 inches.
10 inches? Do you think he's 10?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so he's a keeper in the box.
You bet.
In the box, and maybe later on the grill. Here we go. It's crappie.
Karl catches the fish, and we move around the corner, and he rolls another one up to the top.
Oh,
I seen him. I seen him.
Wow.
I seen him.
Oh, I didn't sting him.
Then I catch two right off the bat, and I knew we were good to go.
Oh. Oh, what a boy.
Get it in here. Get it in here. Get it in here.
Did he hit it and hit again?
Got it. It did. Come back for it.
That's George's fish right inside there. Looks like a little female too, doesn't it?
Good fish.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Right out of the middle of the creek.
Yeah. This is what you got to do sometimes and put up with when you're in the jungles like this. And this is a crappie jungle. Two bites in a row. George had one. I missed one. And when you set, unfortunately, because of where you are in the trees here like this, you're going to get wrapped up. Check your line. And we're going back crappie hunting along these little bushes, weeds, stems, anything along the shoreline for slabs. Actually, John Godwin said, do this. Spit on it. Let's go. I think this is deeper. You got him in there? Oh, yeah.
Like that. There he is.
Oh, he dropped him on the boat. Was he deep, George?
Oh, he hit it on the way down.
Oh, God. Can I put it in there?
Yes.
Pass to it, okay. So I'll pull the jig up like this. See that? The jig's sitting like that. I'll pull the jig up to the rod tip eye. Find my spot I want to put it in, way back in here, and then just drop it in and let the line go, and then I can shake it and bake it right on that little hot spot instead of trying to cast up inside there. And then when I shake it all around like that, I'll just pull the line with my hand like that, pull the jig back up through that, pull it out, find another little hole, and drop it back in like that. Man, you want to talk about effort. These bushes and stuff, you're using 10-foot poles, so there's trees above you, branches, you name it. And those crappie, sometimes they're 3 feet from the bank, sometimes their tails are right against the bank. So we have to look for like the grass, different things like sticks, branches, and sometimes just on a little mud bank, but a little, you know, a little ways out, a little bit of grass patch, and bang, there they were. Oh, there's one right there.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
It's a small one, but it's a fish.
10 incher?
He'll go 10.
Yeah, nice one, George. Want me to throw him in there? You want to throw him in?
Oh, that's nice what I've been waiting on, Bubba.
There were a few deeper holes in the creek, so all the fish wasn't up on the bank. We were hoping that the brush out in the middle was holding some big females. So we would punch through the mat down close to the trees that were overhanging and let the bait all the way to the bottom, just ease it up a little bit, and boom, there's the fish.
There's fish.
Here goes one. Oh, there's a fish. All right, Georgie, right on the point of it, eh?
Right on the outside.
I'm gonna drop in real quick, okay?
It's a good keeper.
Take a look at this potential. Like, we're fishing just a little grass like this, the little bushes, buck brush, whatever you want to call it, overhanging stuff. But there's, from current or whatever it is, high rains, there's little trees and bushes and logs and branches, all kinds of stuff the crappie sit in. George has got that fish sitting on the outside of this little bush here. But you can see there's a log going down, you know, down to 3, 4, 5 feet of water. He was there. But if you look up the creek, you can just envision. But you don't want to get into the habit of running and gunning too quick. These bites have been either right on their nose or down there. Let it sit. Doom. So it's a matter of find the good stuff, dissect it, but fish it slow. Don't leave any fish. Nice and slow.
Man, how did I miss that fish? Yeah, I did say fish.
Oh my goodness, look at him. Black, beautiful crappie. Atta boy, George.
Went back and got him.
Look, blackmail. When you're fishing crappie like this time of year, you have to go to war with them. They're right off the bank. They're tight to cover. They're in little holes. They're around brush, grass, and not always are they that aggressive. They just want to move the bait out of their bed.
We're getting them in the creek, having some fun, but the sun's come back out. We are in Texas. And you know what? I wore the black this morning to attract some sun. We layered up a bit. We're going to just, you know, take a few things off, cool down a little bit, stick around. From Cedar Creek Lake in Gun Barrel City, Texas, crappie in the creeks with the jig. We'll be right back. Put that rod in there, you got to pull the line up, get the jig right to the tip of the rod, poke the rod into the hole, then drop, holding it, letting it fall and feather it. But the trick is getting it in there, you feel that bite, now getting the fish out is a whole nother battle. Here's something to consider. You know, this is like jungle warfare, crappie fishing, right inside those little pockets and holes. And sometimes they're 5 feet deep, sometimes they're 8 inches deep, 10 inches deep. Having a good rod, like the B&M, the SAM super sensitive 10 footer, we can stay back from those fish, put the bait in those little holes, but you gotta be able to feel those little subtle bites. Some are rocking it and knocking it, some it's just melting. It's almost like they wanna push it away. It's still early, not spawning yet, but they're in here. They wanna eat, but you gotta have the right rod, the right reel, line, hook, everything is paramount. But for me, feeling those soft sensitive bites with the B&M poles, that's what it's all about. Fishing this tree here, and George got some real nice stuff, limbs going down and stuff, and I see this little pocket of shade. I reach down, put it down. As soon as I put it down, I see that big flash. Crappie, set, I can't move it. It's stuck.
This is deep.
Oh yeah, good one. Real big one. Get it. He's stuck. We have to go and get him. I see him on top of the water there.
You got him?
So I run to the back of the boat, jump to the bank. We got to get the fish.
Here he is, George, a real good one. Hope he didn't come off. I don't think he did. No, he's still pulling. He's there.
Reaches down, finds the crappie, catches the crappie.
Now this, oh yeah, he's still there. I feel him pulling his head. Now, what do you think of that? Crappie fishing. Is that a dream or what? Like, seriously, look, dude, look how far back he was. You know, the bite was like this. Look, doom. I'm thinking, that is a fish. But I couldn't set in there.
And luckily get my hands on the fish and bring the fish out. And then I take it back, give it to Carl, and I'm lucky I didn't get wet.
Two-man effort catching crappie on Cedar Creek Lake in Texas. Look how black he was hiding. See that back there, that little hole in there? I dared to put that jig back in there. And you were there. You're gonna go in the live well, make some nice pictures. Oh. That was fun. Now that was effort. Hey, George?
Good job.
Thanks, buddy. Let me tell you something, dude. If I watched it on TV, I would say, wow, did you see that show? It was all live, man. The guy had to go on shore and get it. Oh, man, that's fun. Now there's a new thing, hand grabbing for crappie. Look at this stuff we're fishing. You know, it's just a little bank and you think mud, clay, etc. But they're making like nests, looking for spots. There's brush, grass, patch of weed, logs, it doesn't matter. We're just throwing the bait in, swimming it along, almost as close to the shore you can get where you can't see your jig. That's the key here, can't see your jig. And those crappie, whew, either they're eating it, missing it, shooing it away, whatever you wanna call it. So we're just finding all this kind of stuff, dropping it in, shaking it, and swimming it a bit.
Fish. Got? Yep.
Good one too.
Oh no.
That one was meant for the boat, dude. Hey? George, dude, that was another fish made for TV, buddy. Huh?
In and out of the trolling motor.
Yeah. Look at the thick back on him. Show him the back. Look at the hole where the hook was too. That's where they come off when they're thrashing around. That's a beautiful fish, buddy.
Yep.
Beautiful fish. We'll box her up. We're doing pretty good here, man.
Good.
This has been awesome, I tell you. You know what? We're almost done our day. But coming to Gun Barrel City, Cedar Creek Lake, and George's out there for a few days, but the heavy rains, big winds, and he said, we're gonna find a way, some way, to catch crappie. And he suggested we've got, there's canals and little arms and stuff and go up and jig. The heavy stuff, hey, I was in big time, man. This is the kind of stuff I love. It's like, you know, hand-to-hand combat, one-to-one with the crappie. You lose a few, you catch a few, but that's what it's all about. You wanna have some fun in Texas, where everything is big? Cedar Creek Lake, and Gun Barrel City. Now this is fun, catching them, missing them, because you look at it and think, oh, come on, those guys are missing a few fish and stuff too, but I tell you, it is not easy. But is it fun? You bet. Catching them real close to you, 10 feet away, sitting in brush that you can't see them. You're putting the bait down there, you're shaking it, and all of a sudden, boom, there's a crappie.
Oh, I seen that bite. Good fish. Good fish.
Crappie. I let him take it for an extra second, George. Look where he's got it too. Look at that. Right through that top lip, boy. There's no way anybody's gonna miss that bite. It's like, boom. Look where he got it too. Now as for the baits, 1/8 ounce, little ball jig head, and little chartreuse and black tube jig. Thread it up, and you know, it's got a gap is very important, because if you have too much gap here and too much bite, you can see what we're fishing. It's really heavy stuff, and it's brush and grass and stuff that you're always gonna get hooked up and get frustrated. You find the perfect matchup that is just almost in line with the tube. You got a nice little bite there for those bigger size fish to get inside the meat. But the black and chartreuse with the pink head, you know, it's had some floods and rains and things like that, so the creek is a little bit off color. That's a ticket today. There he is. Look at that. There he is.
In the boat.
Buddy, you can't. That is amazing, man. Huh? How many times did
Look
he hit it?
Look at the colors.
Yeah.
He hit it three times.
Wow. Look at the gamin. Hey?
Mm-hmm.
Where he was.
Right on the thin side.
Wow. 10-incher?
You bet. All things considered, we found some good fish, and it was a great time.
Man, did I have fun. So I got a big thanks to the Crappie Anglers of Texas, J. Don Reeve, George, you know, the Economic Development of Gun Barrel City. Thank you all, because you really came through. Wasn't that cool, man? I mean, one-on-one, those crappie hide just like bass. And that's some of the appeal of crappie fishing for me, and I know it is for you too. When you pick up that big B&M 12-foot, 10-foot, 11-foot jig pole, whatever it is, wherever you're fishing, something about putting it in those little hot spots and waiting for that ding, it's just magical. On this next trip, I fished a couple years ago with a guy, Jared Lee, out of Laredo, Texas. He came up to Zapata. He told me, have you ever heard of Falcon Lake? Well, I've heard of Falcon Lake. But have you ever seen the crappie that are on Falcon Lake? Haven't. So I'm proud to say that we are probably one of the first ones ever to film a crappie-specific show on Falcon Lake, fishing the deep wood brush piles with the aid of electronics,
our tree thumper jig poles, some crappie magnets, slab magnets, and man oh man, you talk about January filled with big, beautiful crappie. Never forget it, man. Check it out, because Jared, he's waiting for you, because those crappie are hardly touched and they are waiting for guys like you to go and fish and have fun.
From the border town of Zapata, Texas, on world famous Falcon Lake, it's time for some Tex-Mex crappie, vertical jigging the hardwoods with Jared Lee of Jared Fishing Falcon Lake Guide Service. We're as far south in the U.S. as you can possibly go for crappie, bordering Mexico.
He got one. Wow, that feels pretty good too. Crappie, huh? Wow, Jared, you have got it down to a T, my friend. Oh, yes, man. Yes, sir. You have got it keyed in, my friend. Keyed in. Crappie on a slab magnet right here on Falcon Lake. Oh, he tried to choke that, Jared. Boy, what a bite, man. Boom. But there it is. My first fish right there. My first beautiful black crappie, Falcon Lake, thanks to Jared's guide service. Jared, what's the actual name of your guide service?
Jared Falcon Lake Guide.
Okay. And look what he's got. There's another one there.
There's a bunch of them. Choking a bait.
Oh yeah, wow.
They want the bait.
I'm impressed, man. I'm impressed.
You see your bait now?
Yeah, man.
Right down the
bottom. Got it.
A little lower. Right there. You're in the money. Swim it up. Oh, here he comes. He's going to hit it.
Wow. Dude. That's money. That's money. You know what? You know you're a good guy when you can just call it. You're in the money. Put it down. Lift it up. You got him. Wow. Dude, I see the addiction to live scope and fishing structure. Hey, this is a magnolia, too. Look. He's a mohawk. Magnolia, yep. With the stripe.
Keepers. We're just looking for bigger fish.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, man. Crappie love the crappie magnet anywhere. Ontario, Mississippi, Arkansas, and on Falcon Lake in South Texas. You can't get any more south than this, right? Right, so we're fishing as far in the United States as you can, right? For crappies. And I'm impressed already. Look at that, magnolia. Look at the stripes on him. Mohawk, goes underneath his jaw. Look at, there, comes up. Mr. Magnolia, pretty cool. But not big enough, Jared says. So, go on.
This is a slab magnet that I'm using with this a regular jig head. What we're doing here is I'm having to put a split shot on my 20-pound braid. A lot of people ask, why do I use braid? Well, here on Falcon, there's a lot of hardwood and brush piles. With the live scope, like I'm gonna show you in a minute, I don't think the fish care if it's braid or 6-pound mono or fluorocarbon. As long as you keep the bait above them, they're gonna hit it when you raise it up. Just put the split shot here on the braid. And just so it won't move, I just clamp it here and just crunch it on. We'll see if we can catch one of these fish live. That's a pile with some bait right next to a hardwood, and you can see all the crappie mixed in here. So I'm gonna try to drop down to it live. With this, it's all about boat control. So as you can see, all the fish there. I'm gonna drop my bait down. You see it going straight down there. There it goes. See it there? Live action, I'm gonna try to get the fish to swim up for it. Right in his face. Here he comes, look, he's gonna hit mine.
Double. Oh yeah. Double on Falcon. Wow. In the app. Oh, it's in the app all right.
Keeper crappie, back in.
Yeah. So when you have clients next week, the week after, they'll have those to eat. You see these? Give Jared a call, man, because this is fun. And this is a slow day, man. He said it's slow. I'm still catching fish, I'm having fun. Can't wait till we find the mother load and it just goes on fire. Got another one? Oh, good one, attaboy.
Yeah, there. Crappie keepers.
Real nice fish.
Bring your mama.
Oh boy.
Got him.
That's a good one. It's a nice crappie. You called it there, Jared. You called it there, my friend. Magnolia. So he's got the stripe going down. Stripe a little bit underneath the chin there too. But again, they're just beautiful keepers. Look at gorgeous Falcon Lake crappie with Jared, Falcon Lake Fishing Guide. You want to catch him? Give him a call because it is a lot of fun, man. It's safe. He knows the spots. He's got the brush piles. He's got the wood. He's got the hardwoods, he's got the baits, you name it. Just needs you, come on down like I am, and catch him. Let him go. New spot, big crappie. Is that the game plan? New spot, big slabs. Uh-oh, look at you already in the spot, eh? How deep? Oh, you're 14. Good one. Uh-oh. Oh, Jared, swing that baby up, boy. Put that baby in the box. Oh, that's a beautiful crappie, man. Way to, yeah, man. Way to go. Is it on spot lock? Okay.
Big old Falcon crappie.
Didn't take long, did it? You got right on him, boy. Nice one, man. Yeah, good one too. A real black crappie. Look at that, huh? You can tell the color by where it is, right? Yep. Right inside that brush pile.
We called it too before, huh?
You did, man.
You're gonna hit it.
You did. You did. Looks like when they commit, you just gotta slow down and hold it there, right? Thing right in the black. Look at them. Isn't that beautiful? Beautiful black crappie, boy. On one of my favorite colors. A slab magnet. And you know what that is, right? You see me catching all Ontario with it. Right there, by crappie magnet. That is, I call it gold dust. See what it produces? Falcon Lake, Ontario, Arkansas, Mississippi. It don't matter, boy. Slab magnet, the B&M. And we're using Tree Thumper, designed by Steve Dana, Louisiana. We are still fishing wood, brush. That one should go in the box, no? For color?
Yeah.
Okay.
We got some good ones,
Hammerback,
huh?
Oh, dude. Are you kidding, man? Oh, yeah.
That was pretty cool, eh? As far south as humanly possible in the United States to go catch crappie. Something else, man. Thank you again, Jared, because I hope that we can do it again. And I'm looking forward to picking up that jig pole and fishing with you again, or maybe even go chase those big bass, but we'll see. On this next segment, back with my buddy George Nealon out of Gun Barrel City again, Texas, Cedar Creek Lake. And this time, there's no creeks. There's shooting pontoon boats, bridge pilings, and different things with small shad baits and just having fun. And George again showing me how he finds those crappie, how he catches those crappie with a countdown method of watching how slow that bait falls on the shady edges of bridge pilings on the interstate and different highway bridges, but how he finds them, how he maximizes his time and not waste time looking for those crappie, where they're suspended, and how we move throughout the day as the crappie move when the sun gets higher, shade recessed changes positions, and how the crappie change positions even in that deeper water. Check it out.
Welcome back to another Xtreme Crappie Adventure. We're here on Cedar Creek Lake in Texas, out of Gun Barrel City, and I got to hook up once again with a good buddy, George Nealon.
We're gonna try to catch them on the docks, close to the mouths of the coves, and possibly out on a few brush piles. If no good there, we're gonna go try the bridges.
Welcome back to another Xtreme Crappie Adventure. We're here on Cedar Creek Lake in Texas, out of Gun Barrel City, and I got to hook up once again with a good buddy. 2015 Crappie Anglers of Texas, Angler of the Year, George Nealon. This year, George says we're gonna shoot docks. And high and a low. Shoot docks. Oh, great. There's big ones on them. Then low. I haven't shot docks in them over a year or something. So it's going to be trying. It's going to be a little bit of an experience, trial and error, getting that ring rust out of the way. But you know what? It doesn't matter. I'm here in Texas. I'm after those big fat slabs because we all know everything in Texas is bigger. So let's get out in the boat, get out in the lake, and let's have some fun.
A few fish shallow, but they're starting to move out. The spawn, I believe, is just about through, so we're going to try to catch them on the docks close to the mouths of the coves and possibly out on a few brush piles. If no good there, we're going to go try the bridges.
Oh, here comes a fish, dude. Oh, yeah. I got that one probably on the other side. There's one.
There it is.
Oh, yeah. Feels pretty good, too. Look at that. That's my first one. Uh-oh.
That a keep?
Crappie. Yes.
That's a neighbor there.
Took me a while, but one for the box. It caught your crappie. Let's put him in the box. Little eater. He was probably, there goes one. Another one?
Yeah.
Good one? A little one. Whoa, not my line on you. See, I'm cutting your grass by going on top of you. Look. Yeah. How big is it? Yeah, for sure. 10 inch. You got, is it 10 inch here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, keep.
Nice. Why dock shooting? Dock shooting is a term used for describing the method of placing your jig under a dock or any other solid form of flat cover or structure. You might ask yourself, why is dock shooting so popular? It's popular because crappie absolutely love shade and cover. A dock provides both of these comforts. However, it can be so difficult to cast your jig under a dock, primarily because you're taller than the dock and the flight of the jig will be too high to effectively place it where you need it. Now you ask yourself, you know, how is this technique performed? Picture how a slingshot works and you have the general idea. Holding the rod upright, open the bail of that B&M spinning reel, pull the line down until the jig is about halfway or 3/4 of the way down the length of the rod. Grab the jig head and pull it back, bending the tip of the rod. The line should be at a 45 degree angle to the ground. The aiming device for your shot is the handle of the rod. In other words, the handle should be pointed towards your target even though the rod tip is pulled back. Release the jig from your hand and it will carefully shoot to your desired location. As with any technique, practice will make perfect, and I'm the perfect example of that. This B&M sharpshooter is designed to shorten your learning curve and will get you on the docks and those big bad slabs as quickly.
We fished the boat docks for another hour, but only caught small fish. George then suggested we go to the bridge pilings, and man, was that ever the right move. We caught him right away.
Hey, there you go. Some size?
Maybe a keeper.
Oh yeah, nice one, George. Right close to this side, huh?
Close to it.
Atta boy. That's a keeper, George.
That's a good fish. That's a good white crappie.
Oh yes. Wow.
There we go.
Whoa! Texas, baby. Look at that. Look where he's got that too. Little lime and white. Little lightning shad. What size are these heads, George?
16th ounce.
Real simple stuff. 6-pound test. That's a nice crappie anywhere in the States, boy. Got him? Good one?
Nah. Little one.
Oh, he's a good fish. Is he an eater?
Nice little eating black crappie.
Out of way. So slowly but surely, putting some fish in the live well, huh? Come on, fish.
You
are. Oh,
yeah, oh, it's nice a good fish.
Look at that thing.
Good fish. Did he eat it good?
I think he's got it good, George. I think I can swing him. What do you think?
Yeah.
Take a chance.
Do it.
Clean him around like Bassmasters. Whoa, yes.
Good fish.
Look at where he got that.
Wow.
What a bite, George, too, you know?
Mm.
The distinctive, real authoritative.
Nice fish.
Now you know why I came to Texas? Crappie! That tastes good, even raw, man. You ever eaten sushi?
Yes.
Sushi crappie?
No.
Oh, wonder what it's like. You know, you can use all different kinds of poles and stuff, but that little 5'5" sharpshooter, a B&M, it just gives that fish a fighting chance. You see how it bends. It just, every fish feels good, but when you get those bigger ones, right down to here, you feel that, you just know it's a good fish. So I'll check my line, everything's good. Go get some more.
Instead of wasting a lot of time fishing every bridge piling, George idled slowly alongside of the bridge while watching his side scan imaging on his sonar for fish symbols or schools of crappie.
There he is.
Oh, that one, someone's pulling drag.
You better fish. I bet it's a keeper. Come here. Come
Look at that thing, fight.
Come here.
Oh yeah, man.
It's a white crappie.
Nice one, George. Oh yeah. Beautiful fish, dude. Look at those, man.
Yeah, it ate it.
Oh yeah.
Male. Wow. It's a male fish.
Yeah. He's marking a spot. Want to put it in the well for you?
Yeah, we'll keep this one.
Yeah.
Good. Got it?
Oh yeah, man. Look at that. Look at the backs on it too. George said it, boy. Just keep fishing. Go through them small ones and look what's there. The little hole they make right there. See that right there? That's the danger spot. When they start to shake their head and thrash and stuff, you got to get them in the boat, boy. Otherwise, it's just another fish story. Let's put him in there too. So far, so good. Take a peek. Look at that. There's nothing wrong with that, man. Working on a good feed of crappie. Boy, oh boy. I love crappie fishing, but figuring it out, you know, doing this kind of stuff, shooting docks and side arming and stuff, and figuring that depth on shooting docks, trees, whatever it is, whether you're jigging deep brush, cypress trees, it's the depth, figuring it out, taking your time, being patient. And I found fishing with all these guys like George, the patience, the guy who's the most patient guy, down, up, whether it be Jeff Smith, Godwin, Stone, Tim Blackley, it doesn't matter. All these guys, man, they just know that crappie fishing, they're the most temperamental little fish. When they're aggressive like any fish, it's almost easy to catch them. But when they're not like that, you gotta figure it out, because they will find a way to make them bite. Let's keep going. I know that crappie bite.
Fish.
Feels not bad.
Another keeper.
Yeah, keeper. Look at that.
God. There he is.
The one. He's running. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, yeah. Nice one, George.
Wild crappie.
Oh, yeah, man. Oh, yes. Yes, sir. Oh, yeah, that's a good fish, boy. Oh, that's a keeper, man.
Looks like she's not quite through spawning.
What do you think? Let her go?
Yeah,
you take pictures of her and let her go
we
after?
We can let her go.
Okay.
Let her finish.
Sure. We can do that.
There he is.
Yep. And, oh, look at that.
Good keeper.
Yes, sir. Look at the fight, man. Man, I love these crappie. Whoa, yes. Oh, my goodness, dude. Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy. Look at that. What a crappie. What a crappie. Cedar Creek Lake. Shooting docks. Shooting pillars. Shooting bridges. You name it. Just not shooting the breeze. That one? I'm going to take some pictures of some of these fish. I mean, some of these females will let go for sure. But it's getting warm, it's noon now, catching some fish, start off a little bit slow, but I mean, the rain's staying away, and it's supposed to be nice and sunny this afternoon, so hopefully these fish pull more into this dark, scary, deep stuff, and we catch some more. We gotta get out of this kind of stuff. So stick around, we'll be right back, catching some more beautiful crappie. Cedar Creek Lake, out of Gun Barrel City, in Texas. Ooh.
That's a good one.
The odd one is just 1 out of 10. Get it where you want to get it. All the way through the platform, right to the back. Now if there's a crap.
Get fish?
Yep, crappie. Look at that. Look at that. It's a good crappie too. Oh my goodness. Look at that.
Good fish.
Oh boy. There we go. There we go. Look where he was. Way at the back there, George.
Mm.
Way at the back. Right when you said, good one, he's an eater, isn't he?
You bet.
Yes. Shooting ducks in Cedar Creek Lake. I know you saw me banging off that one, making jokes and stuff, but when you get the right pitch,
and shot right back where it should be. I just lifted up and he's ready there.
Boom, let's put him in the box.
We're going under bridges again. Cedar Creek Lake, under bridges to catch crappie. No, it's okay. George had an idea that the shade is more that way now. So come across into the side of the bridge and pitch our little jigs, the lightning shads, a 16th ounce jig, to that little mother load, the honey hole on the other side. We'll get them. Let's see what's down in the shade here. Got him? Had him?
I hit a bass. There he is.
Good one.
Get up the bridge, get up the bridge. Little fish.
That's a nice crappie.
Nice crappie.
Boy. Oh, it's a keeper. He munched it too, didn't he?
Deep.
Oh boy. Yes. He munched it. Another eater, George. You called it right. Come to the side.
Way back and close to the collar.
Yes.
Try to keep you in line.
There. They sure don't move far if you don't put it in the right spot, eh?
Yes, sir.
Depth and cover, right there.
There he is.
And you know what?
Good one.
It feels pretty good. Oh yeah, it is a good one, George. Oh boy.
Good fish.
Oh, look at this, George. I might need you with here. Oh, nice. George, can you grab that one? See? Come right up to you. Oh,
good
Lord.
Fish.
Hey?
Good fish.
You did say you have to be close to the pillar and dark, right? Isn't that what you said?
Yes, sir.
Exactly. Look where he's got it too. Man, and right through the hard spot. Look at that. I can't even move that jig. It is in that hard spot. Wow. That is a fish that was meant for TV right there. A real Texas slab. Look at that. Wow. Oh yeah. Beautiful looking white crappie. Gotta love Texas, man. Gun Barrel City. Where everything is bigger. From the fish tacos to the crappie. And put her in the live well. Come here, big girl. Look at that. Wow, is that nice. Beautiful. One in there, girl. I love it here, man.
Here in Gun Barrel City, Texas, on the fourth largest lake in the state of Texas, if you can't catch a crappie, we'll shoot one for you. This is kind of
well, there you go, Lone Star State supporters. A crappie special from Texas. From fishing way up the creek to the deep brush piles on Falcon Lake, over back to Cedar Creek Lake again, fishing bridge pilings and boat docks for crappie, shooting it with the sharpshooters. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you subscribe to our channel. Follow us on all social media stuff. You know how it is. But think about catching crappie because they're here for you and me to enjoy, catch, and share that camaraderie throughout the whole world and let them know, because we both know it, crappie fishing is some of the most enjoyable times you're going to experience in your life with the loved ones and your close friends, because I love it, you love it, we all want to do it. Thanks for watching. I'm going to see you next time. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on all our pages dedicated to crappie in the links below in the description section of this video.